What's this? It's the new SV06 Ace, the successor to the popular SV06, and we'll get a look at it right after this. I'm Brian, and you are watching BV3D. This video is sponsored by PCBWay. More on them in just a bit. Hello, 3D printing friends, and welcome back. Today on the BV3D channel, we're getting a quick look at the new Sovol SV06 Ace. Thanks to Sovol for sending this over free of charge so we could get a look at it. We'll look at the specs and features, see some prints, and I'll tell you what I like about it and what I don't like. So let's get into the specs and features. The SV06 Ace is an FDM 3D printer, melting filament to print objects layer by layer. It is a some assembly required printer. Now, while the assembly process is a little more involved than some other printers, it's not bolt on the gantry and you're done, it's reasonably close. And the manual devotes several pages to walking you through the steps. It has a direct drive extruder, feeding 1.75mm filament down to a 0.4mm brass nozzle that can get up to 300 degrees Celsius. The bed has a removable magnetic spring steel sheet with a double-sided textured coating, and the bed can get up to 100 degrees Celsius. It has a build volume of 220 millimeters on X and Y, and 250 millimeters on Z. The X and Y axes move on metal wheels riding on metal rods embedded in the aluminum extrusions, and it has belt tensioners for the X and Y axes too. The Z-axis rides on beefy 10mm rods with linear bearings. With dual independent Z-axis motors, it's able to do Z-tilt compensation. It handles calibration and mesh bed leveling automatically. Accelerometers mounted in the tool head and the bed allow it to do vibration compensation to reduce ringing artifacts on fast prints. And it uses the nozzle as a probe to set the Z offset value and to probe the bed to generate a mesh, which is basically a topographical map of the bed. That helps the printer produce a good first layer. It's got a nice 4.3-inch color touchscreen with a simple user interface that I found easy to use. And there's a built-in camera, so you can visually monitor your prints. It's running Clipper firmware, and you can print from either a USB flash drive or over Wi-Fi. The Ace comes with all the tools you'll need, including these. That's right, it comes with Clipper, and it comes with clippers. It's also got a filament runout sensor, so it can let you know when you need to run out and get more. And if you have the printer on Wi-Fi, you can also take advantage of over-the-air firmware updates. It's convenient because it doesn't involve you having to pick the one correct file from a big list of files on a web page. The printer knows what firmware to download and how to install it. Also, it's capable of printing pretty fast. This is a just under 13-minute Benchy I printed with it, and we'll get a look at several prints in a few minutes, but first, I want to talk about the slicer. And before I do that, let's pop in with a quick word about today's sponsor, PCBWay. PCBWay is known for making low-cost, high-quality printed circuit boards, but they also do CNC machining, 3D printing, sheet metal fabrication, and even injection molding. They sent me a few samples, and I gotta say, these circuit board rulers and coasters are freaking amazing. And the clear resin prints of the PCBWay logo, these are 100% crystal clear. So whether you need PCBs, machining services, or even something printed in a specialty material your printer can't handle, PCBWay can do that for you. Check them out at PCBWay.com. Sovol provides a copy of Orca Slicer for Windows and Mac OS on the flash drive that comes with the SV06 Ace. I'm a Mac user, and I had an issue with the Mac version. And what I mean by that is it wouldn't run at all. The problem was caused by Sovol modifying the Orca Slicer application bundle by adding the SV06 Ace support files to it. When they did that, it invalidated Orca Slicer's code signature. It was easy enough to work around, and in fact, Sovol provides the instructions necessary to add the files to a freshly downloaded copy of Orca Slicer, but it definitely has a janky, hacky feel to getting it working. Anyway, once you launch the modified copy of Orca Slicer and get the SV06 Ace set up within it, you'll see that while Sovol includes several filament profiles for the Ace, they only have a single 0.2mm standard print setting. So if you want to print using other layer heights, you'll have to modify and save this one or create your own. Even so, the 0.2 millimeter standard settings work just fine the majority of the time. If you've got the printer connected to your Wi-Fi network, you can use Orca Slicer to control the printer, send print jobs to it, and monitor both its progress and its onboard camera. And Orca Slicer is pretty easy to use. With the SV06 Ace selected, drag in a 3D model in STL format, select your filament type, and click the Slice Plate button to prepare it for printing. If the printer is connected via Wi-Fi, just click Print, and you can send the file to the printer. If you don't want the printer on your network, you can save the files to the USB flash drive, move that over to the printer, and select a file using the touchscreen to print it. While I prefer the convenience of Wi-Fi printing, either way works great. Speaking of printing, let's see some of the things that I printed with the SV06 Ace. The first thing I printed was the 13-minute speed benchy that was on the printer's USB flash drive. There was a spot on the front of the wheelhouse roof where the filament kind of made these whisker-looking things. Basically, it looks like the overhang was a little bit too much for the filament to stick to the previous layer. There's a little bit of a ripple in the curve of the bow, but minimal stringing and not super terrible for a 13-minute print. Sovol also had a 31-minute benchy on the flash drive. This one came out better, with a few little strings inside the wheelhouse, but nothing bad. Even the little benchy license plate on the back came out pretty good. This is a good-looking benchy. Then I sliced and printed a Calicat model by design, which printed in 25 minutes. It came out pretty good, and though there aren't ringing artifacts from printing fast, there do appear to be some VFAs, or vertical fine artifacts, on the front, back, and sides of the model. The VFAs are the regularly spaced vertical bars here. The effect is almost impossible to see when the model is in hand and I'm just looking at it. I didn't even notice it until I recorded the B-roll. Apart from that, the 45-degree overhangs printed great, and there isn't any stringing. It's a good kitty. Yes, it is. Next, here's the Caladragon by MacGyver. It printed in 29 minutes. There are a few little wispy strings between the antlers and a couple between the tail and the body, but as with the Benchy, it's exceedingly minor. The surface finish on this little dragon is great, and unlike the Calicat, I don't see any vertical fine artifacts on it. The backs of the antlers are also looking good, which indicates good parts cooling performance, and I'm pleased with this result. This little toy Jeep is one of Fix'em Dude's print-in-place vehicle models. It printed in an hour and 20 minutes. The two issues I see with this print are overhang performance and stringing. The Jeep prints on its side like this, which is cool because that lets the wheels and axles print right up through the body of the Jeep. Since they're not actually touching the rest of the model, the wheels can roll. On some of the layers with overhangs, even gentle 45-degree overhangs, like down here at the bottom of the door opening, the filament didn't stick to the previous layer. But it didn't happen at the top of the door opening with the exact same angle on the exact same layers. I don't know why it did that when the 45-degree overhangs on the Calicat came out perfectly. Maybe the print settings are just a tiny bit too fast for this particular filament. Anyway, the other issue here is that wispy stringing, but it's that thin cobwebby stuff that a heat gun can take care of. Okay, let's roll on to the next print. This is the Woven Coaster Set by James the Printer. It's a set of 6 coasters and a holder. The total print time for the whole set was about 12 hours. The holder was about 2.5 hours to print, and the coasters are about 1.5 hours each. While the coasters themselves don't require any supports, I think I should have turned on some tree supports for a couple of places on the coaster holder where the overhangs were getting close to horizontal. The coasters came out 100% great from the first layer to the last. I don't see any issues on them at all. The holder, like I said, has some issues where the overhangs were pretty steep, but this is limited to these couple of areas here. I really like the design on these. They're great for keeping condensation from cold beverages from getting on your desk or tabletop. Now, let's get a look at one last print. We'll cap this off with Aria the Dragon by Luby 3D, scaled up to the maximum 250 mm print height of the Ace. She took 3 hours and 46 minutes to print. This beautiful dark blue sparkly filament is Protopasta Night Before Blue. I can see those vertical vine artifacts on the wings when the light is at just the right angle. And there's just the slightest hint of wispy strings on the top of her head. Everything else on the print is pretty much perfect. There's no crazy stringing between the wings or on the front and back legs, and I really like how it came out. So now that we've seen some prints, let's go over what I like and don't like about the printer, starting with what I don't like. Soval's decision to include Orca Slicer with the printer was a good one. Orca Slicer is an awesome slicer. But the Mac OS version of Orca Slicer that Soval included won't run because of the way Soval installed the printer support files. Soval's method runs afoul of the malware protections built into Mac OS. So until the ACE is officially supported in Orca Slicer, if I update the slicer, I'm going to have to copy and paste the ACE files into the new Orca Slicer application bundle as outlined in a PDF document Soval included on the printer's flash drive. It's not hard, but it's extra steps. And for Windows users, if you update Orca Slicer, you may have to do something similar, and Soval's got a PDF document for you too. Another thing in the don't like column is that the printer kept halting with a fan error when the part's cooling fan turned on as the second layer of a print was starting. It didn't happen on every print, but when it did, it was super frustrating. One of the times it happened, the printer had spent 35 minutes laying down an absolutely beautiful first layer for four of those woven coasters. Then it started the second layer and started to spin up the part's cooling fan, and the printer halted. So I ended up with some single layer coasters, which wasn't a great result. Basically, what was going on is the printer was checking to make sure the fan was spinning when it was supposed to be spinning. And normally that would be a good thing, but I don't think it was giving the fan enough time to get up to speed. I mean, we're only talking fractions of a second here, but that's what I think was happening. Soval sent me a new tool headboard and fans, which I installed, but that didn't fix the problem. After some back and forth with them, they had me disable the make sure the fan is running when it's supposed to feature by commenting out a few lines in Clipper's printer.config file. So if you get one and it does that, that's the workaround. And those two things are really about the only things I don't like about it. So now, here are the things I do like. The automatic calibration stuff on this printer works pretty well. I'm not seeing ringing artifacts on fast prints, so the vibration compensation is doing its thing. I'm getting good first layers, and I haven't had to manually adjust anything to get that. So the bed probing and automatic Z offset calibrations are also doing their thing. The touchscreen's user interface is easy to use, and I like that I can print from Orca Slicer to the ACE over Wi-Fi. Most 3D printer cameras are just okay. And in that regard, the SV06 ACE is no exception, but it's nice that it's included. And even though it's super easy to load or unload a direct drive extruder manually, I appreciate the on-screen filament loading and unloading process. On the unloading cycle, it heats the nozzle and pushes the filament down into the hot end before quickly pulling it back out, which minimizes the chance of filament getting stuck in the extruder. And on the loading cycle, after the nozzle is hot, it makes sure to push enough filament through that it's purged out all of the old material. With the good and bad out of the way, I also have a couple of suggestions for Soval to improve the experience of using the SV06 ACE. First, provide more than just the 0.2mm standard print setting in Orca Slicer. A well-tuned 0.24 or 0.28mm draft and maybe a 0.16 or 0.12mm fine print setting would be welcome. Also, include an unboxing and assembly video on the flash drive that comes with the printer, because that would be useful for people who prefer a visual walkthrough of assembly instead of using the manual. So, that's a first look at the Soval SV06 ACE. Thanks to Soval for sending this over to the channel so we could get a look at it. Big thanks to everyone who supports the channel, whether with channel memberships or by using the links in the description. If you liked this episode, give it a thumbs up and maybe subscribe so you don't miss new ones. Well, 3D printing friends, that's about all the time we have for this one. And now that we're at the end, let's go print something cool. All right, the end. It's the end of recording as we know it, and I feel fine.